Now, in this 2014 survey, for the first time ever, we've actually defined bullying as repeated mistreatment, abusive conduct that is threatening, intimidating, humiliating, work sabotage, or verbal abuse. We did that to put it in the context of workplace violence, albeit non-physical workplace violence. Now, that's a very serious form of bullying and addresses only the serious form of bullying. When you add the phrase health harm to it, that is the language that is encapsulated in the Healthy Workplace Bill, the legislation that has been introduced in over half of the U.S. states. And it is our hope that when that is enacted into law, bully targets will be able to use that law to address the workplace bullying they have faced and get their employer to pay attention to it and to get it to stop so that we can prevent and correct bullying. So in this 2014 survey, we asked people, the American public, who were the respondents to this, do you support a law that would address that abusive conduct that was so defined in this survey? And we got an overwhelming number of people who said they did support it. They had the choice of strongly supporting it, somewhat supporting it, somewhat opposing, or strongly opposing it. Everyone had a chance to respond who had been bullied, who had witnessed it, or who was just simply aware of it. So that entire group of 72% of the public who said they were aware had the chance to answer this question. And 93% of that group said they were either strongly or somewhat supportive of essentially the Healthy Workplace Bill, that the Healthy Workplace Bill needed to become law. And just to show you the strength of that support, take a look at this table where you see support crossing ideological lines. Liberal, moderate, and conservative. And it doesn't stop there. Support for the law was uniformly high, regardless of group affiliation. 91% of men, 95% of women, 88% of 18 to 29-year-olds, 94% of 30 to 49-year-olds, 93% of 50 to 64-year-olds, 94% of those with no college degree, 92% of college graduates, 93% of whites, 93% of African Americans, 99% of Hispanics, 93% of union workers, 93% of non-union workers, 93% of NASCAR fans, 90% of LGBT people, 85% of Tea Party sympathizers, and 99% of Occupy Wall Street sympathizers. Let's get on the ball here, people. Everyone wants this bill turned into a law. Support the Healthy Workplace Bill.